Yeah, we use these meteorites when we teach Bible prophecy, and you know, again, referring to Revelation chapter 8, where it says something like a great mountain falls from the sky into the sea, and the Bible says it just devastates quite a bit of the ships and people.
Now, that's going to be much larger than those that we've examined in the fragments of the mother lode. Fragments of the mother lode suggest sometime for miles, sometime 20 and 30 miles away, the fragments are dislodged. But here, you're saying that the impact of this mountain, this asteroid coming in, this mountain of material like that, is going to be so great. It will actually dislodge shipping, it'll change the water table, and it could be that which precipitates the earthquake that Jesus talked about, greater than has ever been on planet Earth. Now, so that we will get an idea on prophecy and the significance of what you just said, it appears that the scenario is that God will use that asteroid coming in not only to dislodge shipping at that time of the great tribulation period as a part of judgment, where man has said, we don't need God, and they will worship the god of forces, the natural elements, the natural energies, Gia, of the earth, from pagan times. We don't need the God of the Bible, will be their declaration. So the rapture will occur, leave man to himself, and when he comes to himself, when he's left to himself, he is at the mercy of the natural elements without the intervention of God. Gary, I'm sure you and I have faced numerous tragedies with trajectories of automobiles and incidents in our lives, and yet God deflected those because of his protective hand. And the United States of America has been the cradle of missionary effort for decades and generations. But now that we have turned to paganism and have essentially said, God, we don't need you in the public classroom, we don't need you in our lives, we're left at the mercy of the elements without a shield of protection from God. Aren't you glad God has protected us from tragedies that
absolutely
surely would have befallen us?
Yes.
So, back to the scenario. Here we have a plausible scenario. During the tribulation period, we will have a ringside seat in glory looking on because the rapture will occur, and it's very clear in prophecy. These natural elements, the earth will succumb to the natural elements, asteroid, which will not only disrupt the shipping and the elevation of the oceans, but will disrupt the plate tectonics so that it will probably generate this tremendous earthquake. Now, this is a scenario. And a reshuffling of the globe will literally diminish the size of the globe back to probably what it was in the original creation before the flood, 10 to 12% smaller in diameter. And this will prepare for some of the things of the millennial kingdom. Now, we only have a couple of minutes. You have saved the last moments for a very special meteorite. Tell us about it, please.
This grouping here of these three are what's, they're called Campo de Cielo, and a very, very large meteorite hit Argentina. And there's some huge fragments of this meteorite, and I just have some small pieces here. But it is quite heavy. It would, again, be nickel and iron.
It is quite heavy. And as you indicated, here we have the ferric material, and you bring the magnet close, and it just takes over.
Yes. Well, these meteorites that I have here, because they're iron, they flake, and pieces of the meteorite will fall off. And I like to catch these pieces with a magnet and then give people a piece of stardust.
Oh, that's nice. That's not our creator, but created. Yes, I have some stardust here. Tell us more in just a moment.
Well, the last of the meteorites that I have with me, these are stony meteorites from the Sahara Desert, and the Aerolite meteorite group in Arizona sent me several of these and told me that I could give these away to educational units. And so we'll be giving the museum a couple of these.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
They're not of the composition of iron. They do have iron in them.
Yes.
But they're basically what's called a stony meteorite.
Certainly.
There's quite a few of these.
Conglomerated with the host material.
Yes.
Now, this has been a program of unique intrigue. We have glanced at the stars. I have a little stardust on my hand right now from a meteorite, from space. But I really have something better than that, because this book, beginning with Genesis, concludes with Revelation and describes the streets of gold and the home embraced by the love of the Creator and the companionship of all the saints along with Jesus Christ, our Creator and Lord. All of these things awaiting those who've made peace with God through Jesus Christ. You see, Christianity and the fulfillment of all these Old Testament passages together describe a Creator. The only concept of a Creator ever to parade across the pantheon of gods illustrated through and conceived by the mind of man. We didn't conceive of this God. He revealed Himself. And in the course of time, that Creator walked our streets, sat in our councils, loved our children, put our homes back together. He went to the cross. He bled and died. He was placed in a cold, dark tomb. 3 days later, He arose from the dead, and at this moment is alive, knocking at your heart's door. Would you simply get a message from space, not from the meteorites of destruction, but from heaven itself, from the God of compassion? Get a message and respond to it. Would you pray this simple prayer? Just pray it with me from your heart. Dear God, I'm a sinner. I deserve destruction. Jesus died for me and arose for me. I open my heart to You, Lord Jesus, right now. Step into my heart this moment and live. I claim You as my Savior. I will serve You with all my heart.
Creation in the 21st Century has been sponsored by Trinity Broadcasting Network. And only with your love gift of support can this program stay on the air. So write to Creation in the 21st Century, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711.
Creation in the 21st Century is a unique program on TVN combining biblical knowledge with scientific verification. Much of the information that I use on the program is available. Contact us. Just write Creation Evidence Museum, P.O. Box 309, Glen Rose, Texas 76043, or call us at 254-897-3200. We look forward to hearing from you today.